All right, the second method from haloalkane itself is known as Wood's reaction. It's a very, very important reaction. You will require it in class 12 also. Now, haloalkanes, when react with sodium, when treated with sodium in dry ether, remember the ether should be absolutely dry, there should not be a trace of water, form an alkane having double the number of carbon. This is very, very important to remember. Double the number of carbon as in the haloalkane is formed. So, in what way Wood's reaction is different from the previous method? In the previous method, we had same number of carbon in the starting material and the product, but in Wood's reaction, the number of carbon gets doubled. Okay, so since it is always a multiple of 2, you can always prepare alkanes having even number of carbon. We cannot prepare alkanes having odd number of carbon. That is the drawback of this method. So I have taken the example CH3Cl, that is chloromethane, when treated with sodium. You see another molecule of chloroalkane I have written on the other side. You may skip also, no problem. And treated with dry ether, then you get ethane, CH3CH3. So starting material had 1 carbon and product is having 2. Alright. If you have 2 carbons in the starting material, product will have 4. So it will always get doubled. Wood's reaction is a very important reaction. You will require in class 12 also, and we'll do the chapter haloalkane. The third method is from carboxylic acid. As the name is decarboxylation, that means removal of carboxylic acid group, which is dash COOH group. What does this dash mean? This dash means this carbon is linked to some other group. Alright. The first method is using soda lime. Now, what is soda lime? Soda, we get the word soda from sodium hydroxide. And lime, as you all know, calcium oxide. Meghalaya is very popular for lime, so you should know the formula of lime. So, if you take these two mixture in the ratio 3:1, then this composition is called soda lime. So, when sodium or potassium salt of carboxylic acid in the solid state is heated with soda lime, an alkane having 1 carbon less, then the carboxylic acid is formed. In other words, the number of carbon in the alkyl group and the number of alkyl group of the acid and the number of carbon in the alkane will be same. As it is decarboxylation, you can understand we will be removing the carboxylic acid group, so definitely 1 carbon will be less. So the general equation we have written, RCOONa, it could be K also, and treated with soda lime, heated, remember, in a dry tube, we get RH and Na2CO3. You can see within the box, if you count, it is Na2. This is Na2CO3. Wait for a while. You can see this part is Na2CO3, sodium carbonate. Alright. Now, how do you get this sodium salt of carboxylic acid? You know that acid plus base give you salt and water. So, if I take carboxylic acid RCOOH and treat it with NaOH, then we get RCOO Na plus H2O. Now, this R group is nothing but alkyl group. Can be CH3, C2H5, whatever. Now, the next method is Kolbe's electrolysis. When aqueous solution, in what way this method is different? You see, starting material is same, but here you have to take aqueous solution. Earlier, we have taken them in solid state. Here, it has to be aqueous solution of sodium or potassium salt of carboxylic acid is electrolyzed. An alkane having double the number of carbon. Again, be careful. An alkane having double the number of carbon as in the alkyl group of the acid is formed at the anode. So, here I have tried to draw a small setup how electrolysis is done. You know, this is a container in which we take the substance to be electrolyzed, and this is called electrolytic cell. And this aqueous as sodium salt of the acid is considered to be electrolyte. Two metal rods are dipped inside the electrolyte, and one end of the electrode is, these are called electrodes, one end of which is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, another end is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. So the one which is connected to the positive terminal is called anode, another terminal which is connected to the negative terminal is called cathode. So where the where the alkane will be formed? The alkane will be formed at anode. And you see, I have written RR. What does this RR mean? You see, the acid which I have taken is RCOONA, sodium salt of the acid. And this R group is the alkyl group. Now, this is also decarboxylation, so we will take away this group. Okay, COONA group will be removed. And what we get finally? We get RR. That means we have doubled the number of carbon as in the alkyl group. And RR and CO2, they are formed at the anode. Hydrogen will be formed at the cathode. And NaOH will remain in the solution form within the electrolyte. So, this is the overall reaction. Those who are willing to know the stepwise reaction, you can refer to your textbook. But as per the deleted syllabus of last year, this stepwise reactions were removed. But if you are interested, you can always have a look. No need to mug up, but just have a look. So, both Wood's reaction and coal-based electrolysis, they form alkane with even number of carbon, and more, as you can see, in both the cases they double the number of carbon. But you need to be very, very careful in what are the starting materials in the both the methods and what is the method. Say conversions are very common in the exams. They are asked, if I give you CH3Cl and ask you to convert it to methane, so first job you have to check is what are the number of carbons you have. You see, in both starting material and product, you have one carbon. Your starting material is a haloalkane, whereas the product is an alkane. So which method you should go for? You should go for the first method which you have learned, that is reduction. Okay, haloalkane, when reduced, they give you alkane having same number of carbon. So this is the method you should go for. But the other conversion I have given you, the same starting material, but now I have given you CH3CH3. So what difference you notice here? You see here, I had one carbon. I had one carbon here in the starting material, but in the product I have two. That is a clear indication that I have to go for Wood's reaction. Alright, so I have shown you the solution here. CH3Cl for the first one, zinc chloride HCl will give you methane. Byproducts is not necessary to write. Second method, CH3Cl, sodium in dry ether, which is known as Wood's reaction, will give you ethane. Now here I have given you the example with methane. But during exam they may give you chloroethane, bromoethane, chloropropane, bromopropane, whatever. But the idea is you have to check whether the number of carbons are same or they have got doubled. Okay. Next conversion is convert CH3COONA. The first conversion is to methane, second conversion is to ethane. Similar products are required, but you see here my starting material is not same. If you check these two reactions, here whatever my requirement and here whatever my requirement, they are same. But here my starting material was haloalkane, but here my starting material is sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So definitely the reagents cannot be same, the methods will be different. So how we do it? You see, since the number of carbon as in the alkyl group, here I have one carbon in the alkyl group, here also in the product I have one carbon. So which method I should go for? I should go for the first method, that is heating with soda lime. But in the second method, what I notice, in the alkyl group of the carboxylic acid I have one carbon. But in the product, I have two carbon. Please don't consider the overall number of carbons here. Remember, the method is decarboxylation. You have to remove this carboxylic acid anyway. So how many carbons you will be left with? You will be left with only one carbon in the alkyl group. And in the product, you have two. So you have to go for coal-based electrolysis. So this way, you have to channelize your thinking, especially when you do your organic reactions. So we'll stop today's class till here, and we'll continue in the next class.